Welcome to my corner.
Woo! Welcome to my corner. Let's have a talk now. Uh-huh. From Miami to California. Yeah. Check your girl out. I'm gonna give it to you straight up. That's right. That's right. Keeping it real, no things inside.
Let's go.
Welcome to my corner, y'all.
I'm messed up.
Thank you.
is in heaven. As it is in heaven. Not let it be in America.
All right, y'all. So as you can see, I was about to say I'm back, but I'm not. I'm in another hotel. So I literally, we'll talk about it another time. So I wanted to come on here and decompress everything that happened at conference. I'm gonna try to do without crying, but I don't like people who record and cry. It's weird. So if I could summarize conference, I don't think I can. I don't think I can. I don't think there's physical words that you can use to summarize what happened at conference. Like, and here's the thing, like everybody's like, oh, we love Pastor Mike. Let me tell you something. That conference was not about Pastor Mike. It was not about any of the people that preached. That conference was all about Jesus. Like, Jesus was there. Like, I know y'all saw some of the pictures and you saw like all these different celebrities, but even if they didn't show up, the crazy thing was Jesus was there. Like, his presence was there and he met you where you were. And like, it was just, oh boy. Hey, don't you cry, girl. You better not cry, relax. So it was amazing, y'all. And for me to be at this conference, I love Transformation Church. Like, I love them. Like, they don't know how much I love them, but I love them. Them my dogs. Like, if anybody say anything about Transformation, I will fight y'all. Nope, no questions asked. Like, I don't care. Like, I will fight you and pray for you later. Like, don't talk about my, that's my internet church. Don't talk about my internet church. So I love them. And so for me to be invited to the conference was amazing. And I was so grateful. Like, I was just happy to be in the room. And I was even more happy that, like, Jesus spoke some things to me while I was in there. And I got a release and I just was so encouraged. Like, the conference was purpose. Like, and that's the thing. Like, they weren't preaching about, like, you're gonna come out in 2 days. The man was, they were literally preaching on the most basic things, but it was what you needed. Because he said it, he was like, in this room, we have everything that we need, like the next everything. And so he was birthing something inside of you. And so, you know, when you go to conferences, I've been to a lot of conferences. All we do is we get these sermons and they hype us up. And then when you go home, the flame that was just lit, it dies. But this one, like, he didn't lit a flame. He set it on fire, like gasoline, everything. Like, when you left, like, for me, I'm still dwelling in it. Like, I'm just like, oh my God, like, this is bananas. Like, I was on the airplane just like, wow, like, oh my gosh, like, wow. There was something birthed on the inside of us after that conference. Like, if you were struggling to walk in purpose, I bet you figured it out by the time you left. For me, being that I had already started walking in my purpose, it was just a reminder for me. And it was also a check for me. Like, it was definitely a check, like a nice look. Like, Pastor Charles was on my neck, okay? On my neck. I was like, hey, relax, like, calm down. Like, talking about submission, I hate that word. And he was on my neck, like, after he finished, I said, all right, okay. And literally while he was preaching, I was just like, God was like, if you just give me your plans, like, if you just trust me with your plans, like, I promise you that I have what's better. Like, all the things he was talking about, like, this, that didn't relate to me. But when he got to plans, he was, submit your plans. And I was just like, who, me? Oh no, God, I got really good plans for myself. Even though half the plans that I've had for myself have fallen through, you know? And God was like, they were singing this song, I Want You, I Just Want You, right? And I was singing it and God was like, don't you sing this if you don't mean it. And I literally was like weeping on the floor because he was like, if you don't want me and all of me, which includes your plans, Candace, don't sing it. And it was so, like, I got checked, like, it, for me, it was a reminder, it was a check, but it was also like a view, like a quick little glimpse of what my future will entail. So the conference was everything. I was so grateful to be in the room, like, just to be a part, like, just to be there. oh man, they're so amazing. God, whatever's like, they're so amazing. And I'm gonna say this, Transformation Church about to take over the world, y'all. Now I'm telling, listen to me. After that conference and what has happened, they're about to take over the world. And I just wanna let y'all know, either you gonna get on the bus or you gonna get Lyft, but Transformation Church rolling, bro. They on the move. And don't miss it. That's all I'm gonna say. Like, don't miss it. Do not miss this. Like, they're going on tour in 2020, right? Get your butt. As soon as they drop the tickets, just buy a ticket. Trust me, buy a ticket and figure out how you're gonna get there later. But you need to be in the room. Like, you need to be, like, it's necessary, especially for this generation. Like my generation, like, we ain't going to church no more. We like to brunch and have mimosas on Sundays, okay? We don't do church. And honestly, I can speak from my own self, because y'all know I left the church, like, 2 or 3 years ago. I stopped singing, stopped coming to church. And I didn't leave Jesus. I just left the building itself. And this is why I love Transformation Church so much. So I started watching Transformation Church after I left church. So what happened was, after I left the church for about a year, I was watching like Ty Tribbett and I was watching all these other pastors at home. And then I decided to get back into church. And when I got back into church, I also started my purpose. I started walking into my purpose. I decided to say yes to everything, right? And so I was frustrated. I was literally frustrated. I could not figure out how I had been given all these prophecies and all these different things about how dope I was going to be, and it still didn't happen. So I thought maybe God had forgot about me. And so I had already been through my little depression spell, my suicide attempt like a year before. And so I was still like lingering. So I was just in like a really dark place. And so I was telling one of my friends, and he was like, Candace, you really need to watch Mike Todd. And I was just like, no, I'm not watching no more internet pastors. I ain't doing it. Like, I don't want to know any more churches. I'm good. I'm straight. I'm all right. I'm good. Like, I just got back in the church. I ain't really trying. No. And he was like, no, listen to me. There is this sermon called Stride. And it's everything that you're talking about, being frustrated with your purpose. He was like, you need to watch it. I'm like, nah, I'm not watching him. I'm not watching Pastor Mike. No thanks. And so then my sister was watching Pastor Mike. And frankly, if my sister can watch a sermon and not be told to, I said, I need to know who he is. So I turned on Stride and, oh boy, hey, relax with these tears. So I turned on Stride and I love all of the sermons, okay? They're all good, but Stride is my game changer. Stride will be something I play over for the rest of my life. When I get tired, when I get weary, when I think God has forgotten about me, I'm gonna remember to Stride. And so I watched Stride, and after I watched Stride, I binge watched every sermon like it was HBO Go. Do you hear me? I was watching them like it was series, and now I don't miss a sermon. Because it's the way the word is given there and the way they do things is just, it's necessary for me. And you know, it ain't for everybody, but it's for me, and that's good. And so that's why I was so grateful to be at the conference, because I love Transformation Church. They're literally like, well, a lot of people have changed my life, but they're a part of it. And so I was grateful. I had the time of my life. Like, I will talk about this for the rest of my life. And every conference that they have, if they do one, I don't know about all them tours. I don't know if I'll be able to attend all the tour dates, but if they have another conference, I'll be there. I'm gonna be there. Like, I will faithfully rep Transformation Church. They have like a soft spot in my heart. And so that's the conference. Yeah, that's really what it was, y'all. I hope that y'all enjoyed the vlogs. We gonna be back in the corner with the funny stuff, but yeah. All right, I love y'all. See y'all later. Bye.
You. Crazy Faith Tour 2020. Let's give God some praise. Hey, let's go.
Yeah.